Okay, math class, I just wanted to give you some other examples. Because, you know, Khan, I think his, Saul Khan's explanation in that video is really good. You know, it's one of those things that I think it sometimes is helpful to see multiple versions of it. So let's look at that. So again, I have a decimal on the outside of my bracket and a decimal on the inside of my bracket. And what that means is that I have to move a decimal. Because just like I can't divide a fraction by a fraction and I have to flip, right? I can't divide a decimal by a decimal without having to do some other extra step. So, like he said in his video, we're going to move it. We're going to move that decimal over one spot because that's all I've got. It just needs one spot right there. And then, like he was saying, whatever I do to the outside of the bracket, I have to do to the inside. So I'm going to move it over there. And so then now, I still have to bring my decimal straight up, but it's like this is gone and this guy is gone, and all I'm left with is basically like 3 into 15, right? So it goes 5, because I know 3 times 5 is 15, and I have, so even though it started as this, my answer is still 5. And you might be feeling like, well, wait a minute, that can't be. So let's run it the other way and check our answer and just make sure, okay? I have 5. I'm going to multiply it by 0.3, 3/10. That I know that 5 times 3 is 15, and I have one number behind the decimal point, so I'm going to move my decimal point right there. So my answer is 1.5. So you can see that our math checks out there. Let's look at another example here, because again, I know it's super, super hard to get used to, kind of. Here I have 0.21, 21 hundredths, and I'm going to divide it into 735. So I have to move my decimal point 1, 2 places. Right? Because I've got it way out here, so I have to move it in order to deal with it. But again, whatever I do to the outside of the bracket, I have to do to the inside of the division bracket. Well, where is my decimal point here? This is a whole number, right? My decimal point starts right there. Always, always, always at the end of the number, at the end of the whole number, okay? So that means I have to go 1, 2 from there. And so then when I bring my decimal point straight up, it'll end up right there, and I have to fill in my 2 empty little divots right there with some zeros, okay? So now it's like my problem becomes 21 into 73,500, right? If it was whole numbers, that's what it would be. Okay, so let's do that. Where's my piece of paper to help me keep organized? 21 can't go into 7. Can it go into 73? Let's look. I'm sure it can. To think of my multiples of 21, I'm going to come over here and write them out. 21 times 2, 42. 21 times 3, 63. I kind of feel like that's the closest one. I'm going to do 21 times 4 here just to be safe. Yep, 84, too big. So it's going to go 3 times, which is 63, I figured out. I have 10 left over. Drop the 5 down. So now can 21 go into 105? Again, I'm going to do some figuring here. Well, 21 times 4, I just erased it to give myself some more room, but that got me kind of close, right? That got me all the way up to 84. I wonder what 21 times 5 is. Oh, would you look at that? It's 105 exactly. Okay, so 5 times 21 is 105. I have 0 left. I'm going to drop down the 0. Can 21 go into 0? Because again, remember, I still have these 2 spots up here that I have to fill in before my decimal point. So my answer feels like it should be 35, but it's not actually going to be 35. 21 can't go into 0. It goes in 0 times, we'll say, which is 0. And now I'm going to drop down this other 0, and 21 can go into 0 times. Okay? So, there's my answer. 3,500. And remember, it was actually this, right? And it was actually this. That's what I started with. Those were the original places of my decimal point. 0.21 divided into 735, and then I had to move everything, right? So again, let's just double check that and make sure that 3,500 really is our answer. Okay, I'm going to come back over here, and I'm going to say, I'm off the screen, 3,500 times 0.21, right? Because that was my original number on the outside of the bracket over here. That was what I originally started with, so let's multiply it out and just make sure that we did this correctly and that we end up with 735. So there's a 0, there's a 0, there's a 5, and a 3. Okay, I put my placeholder in. I have another 0, that's a 0, that's 10, carry the 1. 2 times 3 is 6, plus 1 is 7. And I have 1, 2 numbers behind the decimal point here, so I have 1, 2. My answer is 735. Isn't that the weirdest thing? So we're going to practice this in class, because again, it's one of those things that kind of takes some practice getting used to it, but that is okay, and I promise you that you can get this.